My name is Pavel Kanja. I'm the head chef and co-founder of Flat 3. The food isn't obviously from these parts of the world. We take Scandinavian, Japanese and Korean sort of cultures in terms of the ingredients we use, the method behind the cooking, the layering of flavors, the use of umami. My background, let's say lately, over the past nine years, has been contemporary Japanese, meaning it's a Western version of Japanese. So the reason why we are doing the food we're doing, it's sort of, I wanted to you know, give Japanese a different light compared to any other Japanese restaurant that's been formed and being formed still in London, where it has the Nobu style of cooking and Nobu style of food. So I wanted to do something different and sort of highlight different ingredients, especially ingredients from Britain. The Scandinavian part was actually an accident. It's sort of in terms of how Scandinavian food behaves very similar to Japanese food. I wouldn't say that I worked under a chef for many years and that sort of the type of cooking I did under a mentorship, that wasn't like it at all. A lot of the food that I've done has been sort of not necessarily self-taught, but self-expressed through just years of experience and working with different types of people. Not to say that I haven't worked with great chefs, I've worked with great chefs, but I've always interpreted my cooking to be the style I like to cook, rather than chasing a name to stick on my CV. There's so many seasons in a year, especially Britain. Yes, we could say there's autumn, winter, summer and spring, but that doesn't justify our menu, because there isn't an obvious transition from winter to spring. Outside doesn't do that, so why would our menu? So it slowly begins to fall away from, you know, your heavier base sauces to a lighter, more blossom style of menu. The people that work here, they're also an inspiration. I can't do it by myself, and we tend to use all the chefs in the kitchen and we all sort of bring the menu together. I like the menu to sort of be a bit more on the side of simple. There is an avenue of health consciousness where we try to use less white sugars to execute some of our desserts. More natural products, more foraged ingredients that have sort of been lost amongst the chefs in Britain. Still having a Japanese element, we do have some imported ingredients. But majority of our vegetables are grown here. The fish is as local as possible. There's farmers in East Sussex, Nami Asai. They grow a lot of Japanese vegetables that we use throughout the year. There's foragers in Kent that we work through throughout the year that harvest more than enough stuff for us to use. Sometimes it's too much. So therefore, we don't need to import so much. We all cut a fish as a Japanese would. It would be backwards to a Western style of cutting fish. It's sort of a bit more delicate technique. Even though the tool you use is a lot heavier than a Western knife. We salt the fish for 10 minutes after cutting to increase the amount of umami in that fish. It sort of slightly dehydrates that fish. So these techniques are sort of, they're not modern techniques. These techniques have been honed by the Japanese for thousands of years. We're only now have Western culture sort of embraced the style of techniques. We also do sous vide. We smoke a lot of things. We cure a lot of things. We tend to preserve then use things as you would at home, for example. As you can see on our pickle wall over there, where the Korean style of cooking comes in terms of our lacto-fermentation or kimchee, we like to base a lot of our sauces on kimchi-style sort of ferments. I mean, I guess that's why we called it Flat 3. It began from a sort of, everyone else calls it a supper club, but it's just an apartment that we use to sort of host a few dinners to get a bit of a feel of what we wanted to do and a bit of feedback. So the atmosphere and feel of the restaurant, it's a bit like that, a bit of a home style sort of comfort where people can just come here and enjoy what we have to offer, as you would when you invite friends over. I like people that are sort of surprised, because we didn't have the sort of media coverage that other restaurants would have. So we like people to be surprised in a good way that they can get something different in London. Like, we're not obviously Japanese, but when people get the style of food that we're doing, the layers and flavors, and understand how Japanese cooking is, then that's actually quite pleasing, because otherwise people just walk away confused. And I don't want them to walk away confused.